Today, we're talking about lace, how to save your scan, how to turn it into a brush in Illustrator, and how to keep the file small so you don't have issues opening, printing, or just working with your files. So let's get started. Your lace should be scanned, cleaned up, and saved in some raster format. That could be JPEG, TIFF, PNG, but if you're scanning and opening in Photoshop, I suggest you just save it as a Photoshop document. And if you're new to scanning and cleaning up a lace, watch my How to Recolor Lace in Photoshop video, conveniently located on my YouTube channel. Next, you're going to open the document in Illustrator. Select it, and then open the Image Trace menu. Image Trace will give you lots of presets you can choose from, but I normally click the preview box and then head right to the custom settings. Set the mode to black and white, and then use the threshold sliders to balance the detail in your lace. Move the slider to the left to bring out more of the white, and to the right to bring out more of the black. Find a good balance so that the details appear clearly, but don't look too dark and thick. Use the settings in the advanced section to get additional options for an even better tracing. Paths give you a tighter fit and more accurate tracing. The corner slider emphasizes the angles in your artwork. For lace, you'll probably move this slider to zero since it's usually more fluid and circular, not angular. The noise slider helps to clean up indistinct or dirty areas of your sketch. Higher values remove more noise, so if you have finer details that need to remain in your lace, keep this value close to zero as well. Be sure to take note of the number of paths and anchors that appear at the bottom of the Image Trace menu. The higher the number of paths and anchors, the larger and more complex your file becomes. So try to minimize both numbers as much as you can. The last option to choose is ignore white so that the white areas in your lace appear transparent. Then choose expand from the control panel. Your lace is now ready to be saved as a brush. But if I do that, I'll be creating a file that's larger than it needs to be. Instead, I want to do a few more things before I save it to ensure I'm not creating an overly complicated brush. I'm going to perform two functions to help facilitate this, and those are clean up and simplify. Let's start with clean up. Clean up will help you get rid of stray points and unpainted objects. Go to Object, Path, Clean up. Keep all options selected, even if they're options you don't think you have, and then click OK. Any stray points, text, or unpainted objects are instantly removed. Next, we're going to reduce the number of anchor points using Simplify. Before you start, select the lace and choose View, Hide Edges. Hiding the selection edges will make it easier to see the details of the lace while you're doing the next step. Go to Object, Path, Simplify. And move the Curve Precision slider all the way to 100%. Then, click the preview box and look at the number of points. The goal here is for the current number of points to be less than the original. If the current number is higher than the original, place your cursor in the percent box and start tapping your down arrow. Keep your eye on the artwork and keep tapping until you have the least amount of points while maintaining a clean rendering. Angle threshold can stay at zero since, again, we don't really have any angles in the lace. Once you're happy with the result, click OK. Define the brush pattern and save it as you'd normally save any other brush. And now, you've got a beautifully detailed lace brush that you can easily place on your sketches, recolor, and because of those last two steps, create much smaller files than you would have without the cleanup and simplify functions. Thank you so much for watching this week's quick tip. I hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to give the video a thumbs up if you found it helpful and subscribe to see more videos like this one with me, Mikkel, your digital fashion guru. Have a fantastic day, and I'll see you on 7th Avenue.